Hey everyone. So, I kind of need to justify this purchase, which is a massive behemoth of a case. It weighs 14 kilograms and it stores a whopping 18 hard drives, which you might be thinking is not very exciting and no one uses hard drives anymore, but it's very exciting to me. So basically, I was browsing Messenger and eBay as I usually do, and I noticed this really expensive case that was on sale on the Scan Outlet store for like £120, which is still a lot of money, but that's substantially cheaper than the actual official price. So naturally, I did what any good tech hobbyist did, and I purchased it. Not because I had a definitive plan for it at that time, but because it was cheap, and that's really all there is to it. So maybe bad decision making on my part, but after this sat in my garage unused for a couple of weeks, I started actually thinking about what I could do with it. And then I remembered that I'm running out of disk space yet again, which might be ironic considering last year I'd done a series of videos called My Homelab NAS Upgrade, and I thought that would give me enough storage to last me a very long time, but then I rapidly run out of it. But the benefit of this is that because it has 18 hard drive bays, I could get hundreds and hundreds of terabytes of storage in here. And I'm not going to do that straight away, I'm probably only going to start with 36 to 60 terabytes of storage. But basically in this video I wanted to justify to myself and you guys why I actually bought this, but I'm also going to explain how I'm actually going to set up the NAS on here. Because there's a few different options. You can have Synology or Ugreen or any of the other off the shelves makes, and that makes a lot of sense. Well, not Synology because they're awful at the moment and blowing themselves up, but many of the other makes can make a lot of sense. But the problem with that is sometimes to actually get like even 4 hard drive bays can cost a lot of money, and often it's cheaper to buy a case like this and then build your own. So that's why last year I preferred a Homelab NAS solution. Now in terms of a Homelab NAS, you can do a few different things. So you could install Linux on there and then you just set up all your drives and expose them with Samba, and that can work quite well. But part of the thing that I want to do is as I get more budget for it, I can put in more and more hard drives into this and just slowly upgrade. And that can work quite well, but at the same time, I don't really want to update config files all the time every time I buy a new hard drive. I want something a bit easier than that. And that means my solutions are going to be between TrueNAS and Unraid. Not that there should be sides, you should just choose whichever one is best for you. But that then brings me to my first sort of decision factor as to which I should go for. So, I mentioned in the start that this has 18 hard drive bays, but I don't really have the budget to run out and buy 18 20 terabyte hard drives. I kind of want to start with just 2 drives, and I'll probably go for like 14 terabytes or 16 terabytes. I don't think I'll go as high as 20 terabytes. But by having those 2 hard drives, you might already know this, but you can do something called raiding them. So what basically happens is in RAID 1, the data you're storing, which in my case is going to be my media files from my YouTube videos, that media will be stored on both hard drives. So then if one of those hard drives dies, which can happen from time to time, of course, I've still got another version of it on here. So then I can run out, buy a new hard drive, put in the NAS, and then all of the data will be copied back over to that other drive. So that is called RAID 1, and that's why when you're looking at NASes, you're often finding ones with at least 2 bays, because they're expecting you really to have RAID 1 or something like that for disk redundancy. But the problem with that is then you lose disk capacity. So basically, if I've got 2 12 terabyte hard drives, for example, I'm only going to end up with 12 terabytes of usable space, because one of them is a backup, and backup is the wrong word, RAID is not a backup. But essentially, you know, some of my data is going to be used for redundancy purposes, and I'm only going to get 12 terabytes of usable space, or more realistically something like 10 terabytes of space once it's actually formatted and everything else. The problem though is if one of those drives fails, then all the data needs to be copied over from the other drive, but that can actually place a lot of stress on the old hard drive. So there are some situations where that other hard drive could then start failing itself whilst it's actually restoring all the data to the other drive, which is a bit ironic, but that could happen. So what is ideal, especially if you've got lots of, you know, big media files to store, is you have 2 disk redundancy. So what that'll mean is I'll start out with 2 drives and have 1 drive redundancy and 1 with my capacity, but then when my budget allows, I'm actually going to go out and buy a 3rd hard drive. And 2 of those drives will be for redundancy purposes, so they're just going to have a backup of the data. And again, backup is the wrong word, because if I had a house fire, I could lose everything, so you need to have separate backups. Yeah, so essentially I could have 36 terabytes of hard drive, but still only have, you know, 12 terabytes of exposed space, and more like 10 and a half terabytes of usable space, which doesn't sound very good. But the beauty of that model is then when my budget allows and I buy a 4th hard drive, and that 4th drive will then be used for increasing my capacity. So that is a very common model that many people would follow, is having at least 2 disk redundancies. Now, TrueNAS does allow you to actually actually add new drives in. But the way things are structured, because it's a ZVS file system, is that it's not really that easy to sort of add new drives as you go. Like, you can do it, but the model I'm talking about of starting off with like RAID 1 and then move into RAID 5 or RAID 6 or whatever it would be with 2-disk redundancy, that is something that's more suited to Unraid than TrueNAS. And in Unraid, I could actually have a ZFS pool, and then I'd have the same restrictions of not being able to actually expand things. But for me, my overriding goal, I guess, is to be able to expand things and have that flexibility. So right now, Unraid is sort of, that's a big tick in the box. There is, though, a downside of Unraid, which is that things are slower, because basically a hard drive might top out at around 250 megabytes per second, which then translates into around 2 gigabits per second over the network. And that's not too bad, because I'm going to actually be video editing locally, and then when I'm done with a project, I'm going to put them in here for archive purposes. But there are some times where sometimes I might need to load up an old project to make amendments to it, so I would then restore from here and do some video editing over the network. And the problem with 2 gigabits per second is that's not always the fastest. Like, you can video edit on that, but ideally sometimes I might want more. And so what you can actually do with TrueNAS is performance can be really good. Like, if I had 4 or 5 hard drives in a ZFS pool, I get increased performance, more akin to something like RAID 10, where you've got your disk redundancy, but you've also got increased read performance. And that is actually quite a key thing, because Unraid will hold me back. So in the cases that I did want to edit over the network, that is a factor that I need to consider, that if I do go with Unraid, I'm going to be capped out like 2 gigabits per second, which is a little bit slow. So that's a tick in the box for TrueNAS. But I should reiterate at this point that both TrueNAS and Unraid are good solutions, and they offer lots of different, you know, benefits depending on your use case. I'm just trying to go through and work out what the best use case is for me. But the next factor is user friendliness. And in general, I think that Unraid is a little bit more user friendly than TrueNAS. And just like anything, I mean, you know, TrueNAS, you can learn it and become a bit of an expert on it, and then you'll have no issue with, you know, using it and everything else. But in general, Unraid is considered to be a little bit easier to use than TrueNAS. And that's actually why Linus created or invested in, I think it's HexOS, which is literally a UI wrapper over TrueNAS to actually make the usability a bit better. But in general, I think that Unraid might be a little bit better for me, even though my background's in software development and I got server admin experience. I think that, yeah, the simplicity of Unraid might win out for me compared to TrueNAS. The next factor for me is I'm not going to be constantly accessing the files on the NAS. For example, if I'm asleep or not video editing, you know, I'm out, then often the data on there is just going to be sat there. So this is more of an archive type system, and it's only where I need, you know, footage from an old project, or if I've made a mistake and I need to go back to an old project, then I'm going to actually use this. And Unraid has a really nice feature where you can actually spin down unused hard drives. So if in the future I had, you know, 20 hard drives, what I could actually do is have, you know, potentially 16 of those drives might be completely asleep because I just don't need the data in them. And as far as I'm aware, TrueNAS doesn't have any feature like that, but Unraid does. Now, at this point, I know it makes it sound like I've already made up my mind for Unraid, but I have got quite a big concern about Unraid, which is that it doesn't have built-in checksumming and bitrot protection like TrueNAS has, because TrueNAS is built on the ZFS file system, and it's got some really good protection for disk corruption and data corruption. And for me, I'm going to be mainly storing MP4 and .mov files from my actual recordings for my YouTube videos, and they are quite big files. Some of them could be 30 to 50 gigabytes, and you don't really want a couple of the bits to change and suddenly find that that file is corrupt and inaccessible. Now, with Unraid, you can actually nowadays have ZFS support and then you get that checksumming, but then you lose some of the benefits that I mentioned earlier on in this video about having that flexibility of adding one drive at a time when budget permits. So I think if I was going to go down the Unraid route, I would stick to the normal file system. I wouldn't go with ZFS. So really, for me, I've got to work out whether, you know, TrueNAS's ZFS file system with the extra protections that that gives is more important to me than, you know, what Unraid offers to me, and that's quite a difficult decision. I would welcome your comments here, because I truly am on the fence. I know that Unraid does have some plugins which can notify you if a file corrupts and things like that, and then you can resort to backups. You know, that would be your solution, is to go to backups. But really, with TrueNAS, you've got snapshots and loads of other things, and I've barely touched on snapshots, but that's a really, really good feature of TrueNAS that you don't really have in Unraid. That wraps up this video though, which really aims to justify this purchase of this 14 kilogram case, which I'm now going to put back in my garage, to be honest, because it takes up way too much space in this particular room. But yeah, any comments, please do leave them. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this.